There's been a lot of speculation recent days about whether Julio Cesar Chavez is legitimately conditioned for this fight. He knows what was written about him in the Los Angeles Times by Bill Klatsky, 3-0 Julio. Oscar is simply a bigger man.
Julio is doing good. He's landed a shot and he moves away.
Even against Patrick Charpentier in El Paso, when it was clear Charpentier couldn't hurt him at all.
Oscar danger zone is when he starts jumping and leaping around.
So it hooks early. There's a Chavez left jab.
Right, Chavez got to be careful now, because once you close in, you better have your hands up.
Hard left hook up top by De La Hoya.
Move forward for Chavez. It's the first six rounds of this boxing match. You don't want any moving forward yet. Don't try to mix it up, but this boy can hit.
And as Chavez goes in, De La Hoya starts to land left hooks.
Chavez got to start connecting with that left jab, because if you do, he's going to get you with 20 more.
Be a hell of a bad fight if he doesn't do something, George.
Yeah, but it's about winning now. It's not about proving anything. Just go out there and win.
They exchange punches. De La Hoya landed a thunderous right hand. Chavez takes it, keeps coming forward.
But he's getting into a firefight with Chavez. I don't know that that's what he really wants to do.
Oh, yeah, he doesn't mind. This boy's got the power, let me tell you. And he's got eyes. He sees exactly what he's doing. Like, he's going to have a horrible night.
Chavez insisted to us that De La Hoya isn't a particularly hard puncher. Certainly not as hard a puncher as Edwin Rosario or Roger Mayweather or some of the other guys that he, Chavez, has been in with. De La Hoya would love to prove that observation wrong.
De La Hoya's got to start working on his left jab now. This is not the kind of fight you want with an experienced fighter.
Keep him out, both of you.
And between rounds, you saw the pressure above the eyebrow.
Now Oscar's starting to operate.
I'm sure Gil Clancy would like to see 30. De La Hoya countering as Chavez comes in. And a low blow. Jab going and starting the exchange. De La Hoya landing counters, but not really commanding for long range yet.
Chavez.
Yeah, Chavez much sharper, much better in this fight than he was.
Jab and dig in. You can make this guy back up to
effectiveness, particularly here in the third round.
Now De La Hoya goes to the body with that left hand now. I think the greatest mistake Oscar's got to understand that without his jab, he's just as ordinary as Chavez.
Again, seems to be open for De La Hoya.
Lead right hand and a left hook by Chavez.
Hard left hook by Chavez to punctuate. How stunning it would be to De La Hoya and his supporters. So he brings the left jab to the body twice. Oh. And then back upstairs. Chavez extends the right hand and De La Hoya lands a left hook over it. De La Hoya lands a straight right. Crowd chanting, Chavez, Chavez. De La Hoya landing another right cross. And a left hook upstairs. This right. Let's count on Chavez. Chavez not busy here. There's a good left hook inside by Julio.
Julio starts to pick up his confidence, and that's when Oscar is more dangerous, when you get confident.
The score with the left again.
Now Julio is landing left jabs now. You don't want that to start happening.
Julio's been surprisingly effective with his jab.
If Chavez gets 2 years older, De La Hoya.
Oscar little nick. Little nick by Oscar's left eye.
I have to say to what Chavez wanted to do. You know, you bounce, you come a little closer to me every now and then, and I'll pay you back. He's using his left jab more effectively now than Oscar's left jab. Oscar keeps his hands low because it's like a gunslinger. You keep him to your waist to draw quick when his hands are up high. Chavez reaches right in and stops everything.
Good left hook by Julio Cesar Chavez. He tries to follow up, stepping up onto the ropes. De La Hoya goes away.
And to take his power away from him.
Left jab jolted.
Good left Chavez.
Hard right hand over the top by Oscar.
Now he's boxing. The referee's in. Watch your shoulder. You do everything you can.
Two good body shots by Julio. Harkening back to the Chavez of old.
Keep him up, keep him up.
Chavez continues to go to the ribcage. Del Hoya just misses with a potentially lethal uppercut.
And I told you there's a 12-inch difference where Oscar's got no power. You got to stay within that 12-inch.
Del Hoya going body and upstairs. Chavez coming right back.
Whoa!
Between rounds here, Del Hoya cutting
is blowing his nose a lot these days. That won't help that little cut on the side to make him swell.
Fight of his own blood. So if it starts to flow, it'll be an interesting test for him. He has 12 rounds, or 9 rounds he's fought against Oscar De La Hoya.
Oscar hasn't been...
Remember when Sugar Ray Leonard got lured into playing Roberto Duran's macho game?
This is one of those nights. You got to win a fight. He's only an ordinary fighter when he's hit close to Chavez.
Chavez following the George Foreman blueprint to perfection right now. You heard George tell you.
If you want good legs, good body shot by De La Hoya.
Good left hook up top by Chavez. De La Hoya willing to trade at close range. Is it the right strategy?
He's got no choice.
That snapped his head back.
But he was hurt by the left hook to the body by De La Hoya. Ooh, another left hook by Chavez.
Hard left hook by De La Hoya. Right on the point of the chin. Oscar trying to explode Chavez as they reach the...
Avoiding that close contact now. He backs away, which is what he should have been doing all night.
Chavez landing a jab and a right hand over the top. If Oscar's in contention or in condition to keep throwing the jab, he commands Chavez from long range. Chavez coming forward, tracking his man around the ring, looking very, very Chavez, even as he fails, it seems.
In the last round, he was able to get to that body.
Hard right hand by Chavez.
Body punch in the last round. Ooh, a left hook.
Good left hook inside by Julio.
And he's showing some of that.
A big round for De La Hoya. Chavez has been a target. And for the first time in the fight, a relatively easy target. De La Hoya said before the fight, he hoped it would go 7 or 8 rounds so that he could punish Chavez for the impudence he displayed after.
Julio Cesar Chavez sometimes is the aggressor, but he doesn't score. Oscar's just out punching him like he's doing right now.
Serious business. De La Hoya to the body with 50.
Well up now, and Chavez is making an awful mistake of following him around. He's just like a punching bag at this point. You always concede to the puncher. I'm not going to follow you so you can get...
Seems to be at this point in the fight whether Chavez can make it through 12 rounds and claim some kind of victory because De La Hoya insisted that he would get a
punishment. Oscar concentrating on the body here in round 8. Almost as though he's consciously trying to set Julio up for something big upstairs.
Oscar's very smart. He gets in, but he stands up and gets that height advantage whenever things get too rough so that Chavez misses.
Oscar landing left hooks and uppercuts. Another one there as Julio came in. Little swelling under the left eye of De La Hoya. We told you about the nick at the corner of the eye before. So both fighters showing some effects.
Now this should not have happened with Oscar. He should not have gotten into this kind of fight. His corner's going to have to rein him in now.
Blood now pouring from the lip or mouth of Chavez. But forward he comes.
He steps over to Oscar's left and he steps over to his right whenever there's danger. And he's hitting below the belt occasionally too.
Hitting below the belt 3 or 4 times there. Richard Steele doing nothing. De La Hoya willing to trade shot for shot with Julio Cesar Chavez. A lot of swelling under De La Hoya's left eye. Looks like it might swell shut as the fight goes on.
Remember, Chavez has been beaten like this round after round before in his life. But De La Hoya, this is new territory.
De La Hoya so conscious of offense with his left hand that he's sometimes susceptible on that side of his body.
Oh, what a left hook.
the meanest looking Oscar De La Hoya you've ever seen.
It must be a fight. Chavez won't come out. He has refused to come out. The inside of his mouth bloody. And
ladies and gentlemen, the challenger's corner advised referee Richard Steele that he was unable to continue. The end comes at the end of round number 8. The winner by knockout victory, and still the defending and reigning undefeated WBC welterweight champion of the world, El Niño de Oro.